episode 88 of my Let's Play series. What are we going to be doing today? Well, we're actually going to be continuing on the crafting area. Like last episode, we dug out this round circle and we put some glass in, and so since then I've put the glowstone in the floor. I was going to wood it, and then I thought, well, I'll bring over some more supplies from home, the original base, and glowstone the floor and carpet it and leave the center here open. So I got the bucket of lava as well, and as you can see, I've domed it as well. Quite simple, quite easy. If you need help doming something, no problem. I'll leave a link to the site that I use in the description that can help you do any dome shape and size you want. So yeah, so in this episode today, we're actually going to attempt to install the industrial furnace. Yeah, I'm not sure how that's going to go, but yeah, we're going to attempt to install that industrial furnace in here. So yeah, alright, so let's just get started, because we got a lot of digging to do before we actually placing any hoppers or furnaces down. So first off, what we want to do, hopefully this pick will, I've got another pick, I remember. So what we want to do is we want to dig this six down, around about six down, six, maybe seven. I'm not 100% sure on exact measurements, but I'm just guesstimating how far we got to take it down. Actually, I've cleaned out my inventory, and I should have brought some ladders so we could easily get in and out. We'll just use cobblestone when it comes to it. So yeah, we're going to dig six down, then we're going to dig all the way around, and hopefully we don't hit any water, because we're sort of like on a side of like a mountain. So there's sort of a huge, like, well, not ravine, gully on the right and the left side of us right now. And I don't want to be popping out the side of any of those in the water. Bit of a pain in the backside, but we'll deal with it. That's why we can't build the collection room. Or not the collection room, you fruit loop. The storage room, we can't build that anywhere near the top. We have to go pretty far down, but we should have enough space here to build the industrial furnace that I want to build. So, one, two, three. So we need to go down three more. Quite simple. We just dig it all out. Like, yeah, quite easy. I should have brought some TNT. I should have got TNT up there. Nah, I shouldn't use TNT. It's dangerous. No, my luck, I'll break something. And I just definitely do not want to do that. So this hole definitely looks deep enough to me. It looks deep enough for what I want to do anyway. So next thing is we want to dig out the sides. Or what? 4-5 out. Yeah, that should give us enough space to install all these hoppers that we're going to be using. So today we definitely are going to be using a ton of hoppers for this. We're going to use the same design as I've got at home. Except this time there's going to be no, obviously, elevator. It's just going to be dropped in at the top, and then it's going to like spiral, not spiral around, but go around the entire thing. And then underneath us, when I'm done, we're going to actually build the item sort of storage system, a big one underneath this. So it's got a lot of work ahead of us. So anyway, let's continue mining. Well, not really mining. So we need to go, I'm just gonna go five in to be happy, because I need the work room. So what do we got? 1 2 3 4 torch, so you guys can see. That's 1 2 3 4 5. Yep, that's oodles. I'm just worried about how much space I'm gonna have, so I'm gonna dig all this out so we got all the room in the world for the amount of hoppers we're gonna be using. Dig all this back. On my amplified survival series, I would have taken this coal in a heartbeat, but I'm kind of rich in coal. I've got tons of it back at base. Absolutely tons of it, so you know, it doesn't really bother me getting it or not. The only thing I go out of my way right now for is iron. For more hoppers. You guys know me already. Crazy, crazy. Alright, so I'll be back shortly. I'm gonna just get all this dug out. Alrighty then, I am back, and yeah, all dug out. The glowstone is creating nice light, but I'm still gonna pop a couple torches back here just in case. You know, we don't want no creepers or anything down here, nasties. You know those nasties, they just like to appear. And we've got more. Alright. Okay, so we're going to go up and get some resources. I've kept all the cobblestone. Yes, I found some iron, which is good. Okay. Oh, it is currently raining. Fantastic. Jump into bed, sleep. It's going to be good. Okay, so that should clear up the weather. Thank God for the turning off the rain sound. Jeez. So we put this, not all, leave one stack of cobble to build, a couple stacks of cobble to build off, and we can put the iron and the coal away. We could grab, why is it still raining? I slept in my bed, jeez. So we'll grab a few stacks of the hoppers, so we'll use that one up first. We'll grab a some repeaters and some comparators. I know I don't have much comparators, but furnaces. Well, you need the furnaces, obviously. This is going to be an industrial smelter. What else do I need? A couple of redstone. I do need redstone torches, but I don't have any with me right now. Well, I've got sticks, and we'll just have to make some. Quite simple. There we go. We'll bring down a chest. We got some trap chests, so that's all good. We might bring down one more stack of hoppers. We're going to need it. I'm going to have to start transporting some of my goods from back to base to here. We've got to start a mine shaft soon. Okay. Let's get started. Let's go. Let's go for this. Torch. Okay, so I think we'll start this side first. I'm going to take it one block off the ground, I think. Just for now. I hear a slime, do you? Can you hear that? It's like over there somewhere. The slimes don't spawn under the water, do they? No, they can't. Hmm. So, furnaces along there. Dig all that out, because that's going to be the drainage. Go. We need access to the top of this. So remember, there's got usually what I do is there's stairs there and there's stairs there. So you can't really see the top or the bottom of the furnaces when you're constructing this. So again, hopefully you have enough furnaces. All good. We can make some furnaces. You know, barely any resources used to make furnaces. Go. And again. Just enough. Perfect. Fantastic. Love it when it does that. I mean, get rid of all these. I hear zombies. I hear slimes. There must be a big cave system we got to go explore later. Alright. So this is going to be the size of the industrial furnace. So, what is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6... 12, 24. 24, there you go. That's the size of the industrial furnace, which is good. Okay, let's get started. So, the first hoppers should be facing in ways. Whoop. 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 Bounce, bounce. Sorry if you're getting sick from me bouncing. They're like, Daddy, you Fruit Loop. I'm like, it's easy like this. Doing, 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 doing. I'm on a pogo stick. Doing, 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 doing. Yeehaw! Alright, done. Fantastic. Stop being stupid, Data. Okay, so what we're going to do next is, now, the original design, usually you just have it run across the top like that. I used to have it like that in my base. And, you know, and then you have the redstone on the other side, and items just fall down, and that's how it normally goes, but... Uh-oh. Give me those back. I want my hoppers back, please. Now, usually there's a pretty big problem is, well, in under load, it all gets jammed up. So what we're going to do to prevent clogging or get things getting stuck is I normally add another layer of hoppers across the top and I face them a different way. We want the hoppers down below to pull the item out of the hopper, not hopper here to force it down. Same principle as the, what's it called, the item sorting system. Same sort of thing, same principle we're using. So we're going to do that to all of them. So I'm trying to build all of them at the same time, obviously, not one at a time. So face it this way, quite simple, quite easy. Little walkways. Damn it. Alright. Oh, nope. We can get rid of the cobblestone at the back when we're done. I just don't know how many hoppers. People are going to cringe on the amount of hoppers I'm going to use for this storage system. There we go. And same thing here. This is the last one, is it? Yes, it is. Fantastic. And we'll top up that. And place. Whoop. I was facing the wrong way. I don't think it really matters. As long as the pop is not facing down, you should be right. So take out all these. Let's just go around taking out all the back pieces here. Like so. Easy walkway. Oh, I need that walkway. Okay, so once we've done that, we're going to run the top. The what's it call it? Okay, so I think I'll start from here and work around. Okay, so what we'll do for that is dig this out, make it a lot easier. Go all the way in a circle. Okay. Oh, well, this is the last one. Yep. Okay. So this one will be that will be the start, and we'll go all the way around and end here. So we put the last hopper here, and then we go like this, all the way around. I can't wait to test this thing out when we're done. So it's gonna smelt pretty much 24 items at once, or 24. You could, yeah. It's gonna eat through anything. This thing is gonna. We hit the wall, yep. Bam. Okay, so let's dig this out a little bit just so we can get to the back. Now we're going to run where those hoppers where the hoppers are facing. We should have left the row there, but we're going to power that pretty much all the way around. Dig all this out. It's going to be one hell of a industrial furnace. Well, you know me, build big or go home. That's what we do on this channel. Waste a ton of resources building crazy stuff. There we go. Whoa! Alright, there we go. Alright. Okay. Oh. This is the round pit. We'll leave that one there. Okay, so what we're going to do is this is the end. Yep, this is the end. We're going to get our comparator out, which I only got 8, so don't lose any. And we're going to put it here. Block. Redstone torch. Here. And then cobblestone. Here. Like that. And like that. And then we're going to get a redstone that we got. And pretty much just run it all the way like that. We're going to use repeaters to boost the signal on the corners here. Quite simple. And yeah, do that all the way around. Whoop. There we go. Almost there. Last little bit and bam. Okay, so now that should prevent. Now when we hook. Okay. Let's put an item in there. A couple items. So it's zooming around It's zooming around. As soon as it gets to here, it'll turn. The comparator will turn on, and it will turn off the redstone. Yep, perfect. So what that will allow, just say an entire chest was draining into the hoppers here, feeding it, there would technically be a line of cobblestone in these hoppers, right? They won't be dropping down into these hoppers here because of the power here, got it? So, when all the cobblestone gets to the end here, it will allow the pulse, the signal to turn off, dropping the current cobblestone into the hoppers below it. And then, yeah, and that's pretty much what it does. So that technically spreads out the items between all the hoppers. So they should have pretty equal amount of items between all the hoppers, alright? That's exactly why we've done that. Now, you could do the lazy man's way and literally just have it feed into one hopper, and when that hopper's full, fill, feed into the next one, so on and so on. But this way, as I was saying, it's gonna be spread out. Just say that's just a spreader router. Whatever, Data, you Fruit Loop. Okay, so let's start thinking where we're gonna put these that chest, because we need an input here. So I'm thinking the input chest should be on the side here, and the coal chest should be on the side here. Well, that's what I'm thinking anyway. So let's break this and dig a few down, I suppose. Ooh, always cringe when I fall down gaps. So we bring it back like that. There we go. Alright. How are we going to get out of here now? Crikey. Just, well, be careful. There is lava nearby. We've got to be extra careful. Okay, so up we go, and what we'll do is just, yep, get normal chests out. That's exactly why I brought them, and put it across way like that. Alright, so that's our input for the items that come through. Yep. Okay, so let's get started on the next bit, which will be the coal input. So the coal input has to be, the coal input's going to be similar, all the same. Top that up. I'm going to bring it back by two. All the way, like that. How the hell is that turned out around the opposite side? What the bloomin' hell? Oh, it must have been the torch. Okay, doesn't matter. I was just freaked out just then. I was like, what the hell? Okay, so we dig this out. You can hear those zombies and stuff going on, eh? Actually, we'll eat a bit of chicken before I move that up. Actually, I don't need my axe, so let's put the torches down near my axe for now. I'm gonna check that out later on. Okay, so we need to break in to this side. Yep, like that. There we go. And we just pretty much keep going around, going, yeah, double. Again! That's it. They're going on the floor. There we go. So that brings it away from there, and then the redstone up there won't interfere with this one, because I'm going to do exactly the same thing down here, so the coal spreads out evenly between all the hoppers and doesn't get all used by one hopper at a time. Good idea. Well, don't worry, we'll test it at the end of this video to see if it all works. It bloody better all work. There we go. And again. Getting on my nerves. Can't do any data rage. People will be, yeah, no data rage. There we go. We can dig that out. And I think this should be the lungs turn. I should have just dug all this out in the first place. Was that the last turn? Yes, it was. There we go. Hang on, I'm just gonna check if it's the last turn. Going around in circles here is making me dizzy. Yeah, it was the last turn, because that there is the, yep, that's the start. Alright. All good. No, you don't. No, you freaking don't. I better have enough hoppers for this. Seriously. Okay, so that's all done now. All we have to do is, yeah, did I just knock redstone out? No, I didn't. Phew! Okay, so we go back to the beginning, which was where? Here. This is the beginning, yes it is, because that's the start. And we are going to pretty much, Fruit Loop, wrong way, there. That's not, I meant to go to the end, so just apologize about that. Lemon. Crikey. Okay, so this will be the first starting one, and then we just pretty much walk it back. We're doing exactly the same at the top, and we'll put also redstone there. Okay. And turn it. Jump up here. Uh-oh. We should have enough hoppers. I did bring quite a few stacks. If not, I'll just run home and get some more iron and make some... Actually, I've still got a few left back at home, so that's all good. Once the chest storage room is built, that is going to be fun, bringing all the items back from the old base to the new base, won't it? I can still hear those slimes. Can you hear them? Right here. Like an ankle biter or something back there. Crazy. There we go. And that should have been... That should be the... Yep, that's the input section. Fantastic. So what we're going to do now is... These should be on the bottom. What we're going to do now... Same thing. We're running cobblestone at the back here, which will become redstone eventually. Quite simple. And we replace that torch. Ah, what the bloomin' hell happened there? There we go. Alright. There must be a monster cave behind there. That's gonna annoy me, so we gotta light that sucker up eventually. That is definitely gonna annoy me. And yeah, so I guess the gap behind here was perfect, because this is it. Once this redstone goes in, she's technically should be fully operational and ready to receive stuff. Which is fine, because I got plenty of sand to melt down. You guys know the freaking live stream that I did, the 6-hour live stream of the sand placing. That was intense. Okay, so we're at the end here. Same thing as last time. Pomp, pomp, pomp. And we need our comparator, which we got 7 of them. Here, and our torch there, going down like that. Okay, same thing, run it right to the edge, bring out your, these guys here, which will boost the signal. And we're almost done, and we can test this guy out, and see if it's alive. Yep. Oh, forgot to boost the signal. I was wondering why that wasn't on. Okay, fantastic. So, I don't have any coal with me. I just got rid of all that before, too. So, I guess that's going to be the input there. And we will bring it up one. Because remember, I want it to, I don't know where I want it to be now. Hang on a sec. Just going to put a hole. Because I want, that's the smelting input, so that over here will be the, this will be the, whatchamacallit input, the coal input, the fuel input, so that's better. Okay, so we can run this all the way. Man, there's stone blocks going in these hoppers, man, there's going to be junk in the line. We've got to gotta watch that. We gotta actually check all the hoppers out. There we go. Whoop, getting stuck there for a bit. Okay. Ah! You Fruit Loop. Okay, and then chest. We'll leave it open for now because I wanna go. I brought over some coal specially to test it out. And it's still bloody raining. Freaking hate the bloody rain. Yep, I brought over plenty of coal blocks. We can go ahead and put these away. We can go ahead and put all that away for now, and we can start turning this back into stacks and stacks. There we go. Whoop. Don't waste the coal. Okay. So first off, we've got to check all the hoppers for anything in it. I haven't placed the hopper there because I want to fill this full of some fuel first. And we will... Oh, yeah, I've got one stack. Cool. We will go check that right now. Ouch. Okay, dig this up a bit. So the output will be down below there. It's quite easy. We're not building an output now because this sucker here is going to be hooked up to the... What's it called? The massive storage room down below. So everything that gets smelted will go automatically down into the storage system. Get it? Okay, so first off, we're going to quickly... Yeah, that can stay. Actually, we'll get rid of that. We need a fresh test. So this sucker should be good to work. I'm just making sure there's nothing in the lines. Yeah. Oh, there. Because, yeah, all the stuff we've been mining, of course, things have been making it into the hopper lines. Not the hop, yeah, the hopper lines. The pipelines. Hopefully that's it. Alright, so what we'll do is go up now. I really should bring those ladders over, shouldn't I? There we go. Okay, so now we put the chest here. There you go, it's unloading. I don't know if we're going to be able to see the it go off. Because it's behind there, isn't it? Alright, let's see if we can break in for now. Yeah, I can see it. It's flashing. That there flashing, it should be spreading out. Should be spreading out all the coal blocks. So, two coal blocks, two coal blocks, two coal blocks, two coal blocks, two coal blocks. See, it's spreading it all out. So next it'll be three coal blocks. Alright, let's just wait a couple of seconds. I can see the light just through there. Can you see it flashing? So every time that flashes, it technically should add a block. See? Four. Four. So we're up to four so far. So as soon as the line gets full, flashes. Come on, flash again. It should be five. No? Did we use up all the... Nope, five. Yes. No, maybe not. Oh yeah, no, it just took a while. I didn't wait for it to flow inside. Alright, six, same, it's all spreading out. Six, eight, well, that's got a little bit more, but it is spreading out. It's fantastic, alright. So, it is working really, really well. Okay, so now the real test. We're going to go get some cobblestone and turn her on. So let's do the same as the other side, get rid of this side. Don't you dare suck up the chest. Of course. Fantastic. Now the chest is somewhere in the line. Oh, well. Nothing you can do. So I'll grab some... I'll grab a few stacks of cobblestone. Not too many. Just a few. Quickly go get that chest out of the line because or else it's not going to turn on. Like I want it to turn on. So that chest should have ended up here. Thought so. See, that's all splitting up nicely. Yep, we got some 10s. We got some 14s. So it is not exactly even, but it's still better than fill up this one, then go to the next one. Fill up this one, go to the next one. It's spreading it out between all the chests. That's exactly what I was going for. Eat some more chicken. No, haven't got disturbed by any mobs today. Freaking fantastic, isn't it? Okie dokie. So, let's do this. Let's get a fired up. So we'll put not all of them in there. I want to keep one stack. Grab our chest out. Bam. All right. Let's wait for the good news. Please give me good news. It might take a little bit for the cobblestone to drain in, but watch those furnaces. Oh, there we go. Oh, fantastic! Industrial furnace operationable. Oh man, that is so awesome. There you go. Industrial furnace is currently smelting. So all you have to do now is you take your hopper and you put your hopper underneath the furnaces, and it will suck out any item that goes in there. And then all you do is use upside down stairs here and here, going up, you know, same line as that, and then all this will be hidden behind the wall and you won't see it. How awesome is that? Oh, such a good feeling. Such an awesome feeling. Woof. Oh, I was a bit stressed about that, but it turned out all good. Okay. All right. I guess we're going to call this episode. We've got the industrial furnace in. I'm going to put up some walls here now. Quite simple. Don't need to show you guys how to put up a wall. But the industrial furnace is in, and it is working. Oh, man, that is awesome. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching episode 88 of my Let's Play series, and join me for episode 89. I'll catch you all later.